Hi, my name is George Asimenos, and today I'll make an introductory video on precisionFDA. precisionFDA is a live website at precision.fda.gov, and it's a community platform for next-generation sequencing assay evaluation and regulatory science exploration. Now, when we say regulatory science, we don't mean the science of gene regulation and promoters and enhancers, but rather, as this slide shows, regulatory science is the science of developing new tools, standards, and approaches to assess the safety, efficacy, quality, and performance of all FDA-regulated products. The FDA launched precisionFDA earlier this year and invited a lot of community participants to get early access. These are some of the logos of the first few participants on precisionFDA, together with the headshots of some famous professors and some not-so-famous grad students. When someone logs into precisionFDA, the welcome screen allows them to perform a few tasks and get familiar with the platform. At the top, you see there are different areas such as discussions, notes, files, comparisons, and apps, highlighting the different features of precisionFDA. For example, if we click on files, we see a list of files that are being shared with the precisionFDA community, and that's a feature where anyone can download or share files with the rest of the participants. For example, this data set here that is called NA12878-NIST is the characterization of reference material by NIST. And anyone on precisionFDA can upload their VCF file and compare it against NIST. They would do that by conducting a comparison, by setting up their comparison with a test set of their own VCF and using as benchmark set the aforementioned NIST file, they can take a closer look as to how their results compare to the NIST results. This is an example of people evaluating the performance of their pipeline using a known reference sample. In particular, you'll see that the comparison framework on precisionFDA gives you information such as the number of true positives, and false negatives, as well as statistics such as precision, recall, and F-measure. But comparisons aren't the only things one can do on precisionFDA. There's also the ability to run software pipelines or apps that can do pretty much anything so long as they run on Linux. As an example, you'll see here a few of the pipelines that have been contributed by the community, including simulation tools that can be used to evaluate software pipelines by creating a simulated data set. When someone runs one of these pipelines, they are presented with a screen where they need to enter input parameters. For example, the simulation creates reads from a VCF file and a BED file, and once they choose all the parameters, it will run on the cloud, and in this case, a few minutes later, they'll be able to see what is the result of this execution. They can share these results with the world, or they can download it, or they can let anyone else track and see exactly what ingredients were used to create this result, which is very important in people communicating with each other so they can see this great useful graph of information. Finally, when they're done with all their experimentation, they can tell the world about it by creating a note. This is an example of a note using rich text where someone describes what they've done, and on the right-hand side, they've attached artifacts such as files or jobs or even apps and comparisons on precisionFDA. And finally, if someone needs to tweak someone else's pipeline, they can actually go right ahead and even edit a shell script that runs stuff on the cloud and create their own version and contribute that improvement with the rest of the community. Lastly, there's an opportunity for people to discuss, and that discussion feature can also be used for challenges. This is an example of the first precisionFDA challenge that ran earlier this year. We'll talk about more of these features in upcoming videos. Thank you.